Okay, everyone, we're back. We are in our wonderful pirate hideout, which just so happens to be the prison. And we're supposed to be talking to everybody. So, let's start with Eleanor.
What else do they have in common?
What are you up to?
I'm compiling everything we know about Earth Pulse points, starting with what the ones in Ward Forest and Palamedes have in common. I'll compare those points with the ones that didn't have any Therians. Then, I'll factor in everything I currently know about the Abbey's deployments. Once that's done, I'll match all that information against what we know about the locations Lafayette was able to sense. When that's completed, we should be able to tell which locations are more likely to house a Therian.
You're really going all out, aren't you?
Must you sound so incredulous? If you're going to do something, then give it your all. There is no other way to live.
Right. I'm counting on you, then.
I'm not doing this for you. This is for me and for Lafayette. Do you even understand why that boy's trying so hard?
Yeah, I do.
And it's very sweet, and I love him so much. But also, thank you, Eleanor. Thank you. That's very helpful. I'm going to skip Lafayette for the moment. Excuse me. Okay, fine. I can't get that orb.
Oh, hey, Velvet. You don't mind if I give Kudogane that orichalcum you fished up, do you?
Doesn't matter to me. But do you really think he can make a weapon with that?
Well, I don't know. What does the expert think?
Conventionally, no, it's impossible. But when has convention ever stopped a demon?
I won't argue that.
We're dealing with the hardest metal in existence. But I'm ready to cast aside all doubt. To focus everything on forging my greatest creation.
If anybody can do it, it's you. Good luck, Kurogane.
Yeah, best of luck. If you can make Rokuro stronger, you'll be helping me out too.
And he's gone! Gone to get some work done, but also gone so that I can get my orb. Thank you for telling your friend to move. With Kurogane Orichalcum Stormquell, Shigure is sure to fall next time we cross swords. Ha-ha! Good. Aha.
Have you been practicing your dev impression, Velvet?
No.
What? No?
Now. A performer in Mogilu's menagerie has to be more diligent than that. What if we're stopped at a checkpoint and the guards ask you to perform a trick?
If that happens, I'll show them my trick where I devour an entire witch faster than the blink of an eye.
Oh-ho, that would be a sight indeed. But seriously, if you ever want some magic tricks up your sleeve, let me know and I'll teach you some. Just 10,000 gold each.
No. Steady practice is the key. If you don't put in real effort, you'll never be the real McCoy. You have to perfect your art, be it juggling or vengeance. No, I don't want you. Oh. You can give me a nickname if you want. Okay.
Lafayette, I spy!
I can't, Kamawana. I've got stuff to...
I spy with my little eye something that starts with V.
Okay, I'll try. Is it Velvet?
No fair! How'd you do it so fast?
Wait, Kamawana, I'm sorry. You don't have to cry.
Poor Fee.
My god, don't cry at everything, little child. Jeez. Oh, Lafayette again.
Hey, what do you say we track down another Therian?
Sure. From what I can tell, the next closest Earth Pulse point is near the center of Midgand.
Midgand, huh? The capital's not far from there. I wonder how things are now that Griffin's gone, though.
Only one way to find out.
Maybe so, but Eizen's not here, you know. You're right. I haven't seen him in a while. We should probably ask Benwick where he wandered off to.
Yeah.
Hold on. There's a letter here.
Did he leave?
On pretty cutesy stationery, too. Let's just have a quick look-see.
Wait.
As the cold turns bitter and the snow piles up on the mountains, I cannot help but think of you and hope you are in good cheer. As for myself, I am the same as ever, although I recently acquired a rare item that I shall be sending your...
It's rude to read other people's letters, you know.
Yeah, but how else are we supposed to find out whose it is?
Does it say who the sender is? Uzfamiwu Wexov.
Who the hell is that?
Probably someone on this island, if I had to guess.
Hey! Anybody lose a letter?
Do any of these folks look like the type to write a fancy letter?
Point taken.
It could be one of the pirates. Why don't we go to the docks and ask around?
Fine, just don't forget our mission.
Ooh, this is very interesting. All right. Eizen, what's going on?
No reply this time either?
Nah, but she's doing okay. I can say that much.
Oh!
That's good to hear. I can rest easy then.
That's his name.
How's about getting that pot wrapped? I've got this new sunflower printer. How's that sound?
Yeah, that one's cute enough. Let's go with that.
Did he just say cute?
He's sending stuff to Edna!
Help you with something?
Someone dropped this letter. Do you have any idea who it might be?
You didn't read it, did you?
Wait, it's yours?
We didn't read it. Much.
You really didn't read it?
No, of course not.
Put this letter in with the package.
Hughes got it! When you ship with the Turtles Express, rest assured your mail is in good hands!
If you're done here, we're ready to head out. Our destination is Midgand.
Yeah, I'm all set.
Was he sending a gift to someone? And with a letter, too.
Gotta be a lady friend, that's for sure.
You think? Either way, that letter was really polite. And did you see that penmanship?
Yeah, I didn't know old Reeps had it in him.
I can hear you two, you know.
Oh, God!
I noticed you've come up with your little name for the kid. You sure are the sentimental type, aren't you?
Oh? Calling him Fee doesn't cost me anything. And it's not like I gave it much thought.
That may be the case, but no one else has taken even that token effort. And in doing so, I wonder if maybe you were trying to encourage him to be his own being. After all, one requires a name before he can consider his own identity. Having been given a name, he realizes he is his own entity, separate from others, and a certain formless essence comes to life inside him. And you're the one who set that process in motion for the kid. Whether you intended to or not, you changed him from a puppet into a living being.
So what's your point?
I've been with you since the start of this journey, haven't I? Wouldn't kill you to give me a nickname, would it?
I've never really thought of us as being that close. And besides, you just forced your way into the group.
Come now! I know you've got a bigger heart than that! Surely you have it in you to give a nickname to a dear friend!
We're not dear friends. And even if we were, I'm not good at nicknames anyway.
Please, I'm begging you!
Okay then. Moggy.
Oh, come on, that's so obvious. Can't you put some heart into it for your dear friend?
Fine. Lou.
Do I look like an old man to you? I'm not even trying!
Okay, then. Witchy Mick Witcherton.
Interesting. Well, if I had to rank it against 1,000 other nicknames, I'd probably put it at number 1,011. A nickname needs to have charm. It needs to leave a lasting impression.
Sure, then. Hattie.
Now you're just saying what you see!
Book skirt.
Book skirt!
Not better either!
Ms. Creepy Eyes.
That's just an insult! Look, no nicknames based on what you see, and especially no slandering!
Lil Miss Witch who smiles around you but stabs you in the back when you're not looking.
Hey, that's personal information!
Look, I told you. I'm not good at coming up with nicknames.
Forget it! I should have known this wouldn't work!
Yikes! Better watch what we say from now on.
Yeah.
Witchy McWitcherton and Bookskirt. Those are my favorites.
What happened to those octopuses?
Dial and Kurogane took them to the kitchen. They said they were going to make dinner for Kamoana.
They're going to feed demons to her?
Etheria needs malevolence to survive.
That's why they carried them off alive.
What do they plan on making?
octopus ink pasta with takoyaki and fried octopus on the side, and Helvetian octopus carpaccio.
Do they have a takoyaki pan here at the prison?
Kurogane hammered one out with some iron, along with a large pot for the pasta.
Still looking like that? Takoyaki would hit the spot right about now, though.
Octopus ink pasta, huh?
Like squids, octopuses release ink as a defensive mechanism. But theirs is made of different stuff, and is used in other ways. Squid ink is stickier, and acts like a decoy. But octopus ink spreads out like a cloud of smoke. But squid ink has 30 times the savory flavor, so octopus ink isn't used in pasta all that often.
Luffy told me the same thing. He said that's why octopus ink pasta isn't very good.
Luffy said that?
Yeah, so I ended up not making it for him. But I wonder... I guess it doesn't matter, since I can't taste it now.
I'll taste it for you then. So make me some octopus ink pasta sometime, all right?
All right. And I'll be sure to make some that doesn't come from demons.
Oh, that is so adorable! Yes, who is that letter for?
Hey, who did Eizen send that letter and cooking pot to, anyway?
I don't want to think about it. That walloping still stings.
You've got to be curious, though, right?
Maybe.
It was serious stuff. Whoever it is must be important to him. A lover, maybe.
Eizen's lover?
A child wouldn't be happy with that cooking pot, and a man wouldn't want it wrapped up so pretty. A young woman with Eizen's tastes, then. He'd be bound to fall for a miraculous match like that, right?
I don't know. I bet she's that girl with the yellow umbrella.
You really have a thing for her, don't you?
I do not. That's not what I mean.
Then pray tell, what do you mean?
Huh?
Eavesdropping, Eleanor? How unseemingly rude of you. Besides, Luffy said he's free to like whomever he chooses.
You're one to talk about eavesdropping, Moggy Lou. Anyway, it's just that the sunflower design on the wrapping reminded me of her.
Now that you mention it, but does it really matter? He has someone to write to in any case.
True. I can't help but feel a bit envious.
What a nice way of summing it up, Velvet. So you were eavesdropping too, then.
Oh my gosh! So
say,
many-
Say, what do you think about Eizen?
Oh, so that's the kind of guy you're into, hmm?
Huh. Not what I'd expect, but...
No! I just feel there's something different about him. The way he picks presents, the objects that catch his eye.
Oh, is that all? Boring.
No kidding. All men have some kind of particular interest, big or small.
I suppose that's true, but he seems a bit, shall we say, overly obsessive?
Now that you mention it, he does have a tendency to ramble on about various topics.
And it's not just the items he collects.
There's more to it?
Every weekend, he eats curry for dinner, and every time we go into port, he docks at the third bollard.
Come to think of it, I heard the galley crew complaining that he always needs his pasta cooked exactly the right way.
And when he needs a new outfit, he always goes to the same tailor and returns with identical clothes and boots. It all has to be exactly the same size and in exactly the same color. Turtle says he's very nitpicky.
Sounds like he's not so much picky as he is a pain in the ass.
But I do see a different side of him now. I thought pirates were all rough and filthy, but it seems they can be quite meticulous.
Not much of a reassessment.
I really like that, though. That's very interesting insight into Eizen, which I want, so that's awesome.
It must not feel great only ever getting tails, I bet.
Nah, I don't really mind that much. It's way too late for me to start letting that bother me.
Yeah, but wouldn't it be nice to get heads at least once? Hell, I know I'd like to see that, and I bet Luffy said here does too.
Yeah, I do.
Right? That's why I've brought something a little special. Ta-da!
What's so special about that coin? It looks identical to the one Eizen already has.
The front side does, yes. But both sides of the coin are actually heads. I had Kurogane make it for me custom. If both sides are heads, then not even the Reaper's curse can stop it.
Well, yeah, but that's cheating. What's the point in getting heads if it's rigged that way?
It's not cheating. It's called effort and hard work.
How?
If you always work hard and never give up, you'll make your own way forward. All right, I'm in. I'll get that heads for you.
Okay.
What?
That crow just flew off with the coin.
Those birds are attracted to shiny objects, I suppose. Damn it! I can't even win against a crow.
Don't sweat it. I figured something like this might happen, so I had a backup ready. Go on, give it a shot. You'll show that curse who's boss this time.
Oh, no.
All right, here goes.
I don't believe it. Now Prince Percival's griffin's gone and eaten the other coin right out of the air.
Are you kidding me?
Not to worry. I've got a spare backup. It's time to put that curse on notice.
Right. Here I go.
Oh my goodness!
You gotta be kidding me. Reaper's curse or not, does it really have to go this far over a damn coin?
It's fine, really. I had a feeling it'd turn out like this.
Well, I sure didn't.
Yeah, me neither.
Okay. Sounded like it exploded, really. But, excuse me for a moment. Something's going on down here.
May I ask you a question?
Yes, you may.
What?
You're an Earth Moloch, yes? Why live on the sea when your kind sinks in water?
I live on the sea because I'm an Earth Moloch.
I'd be curious to hear more.
Eifried used to go on about how we should accept what we were born with. But one time he joked about the idea of a pirate who couldn't swim, and he laughed and laughed. I wanted to clobber him right then and there, but it wouldn't have changed the fact that I can't swim. I didn't want some predestined elemental affinity to control who I was. Instead, I underwent tough training to overcome it.
Well, I guess that's one way to approach it. Did this training of yours bear any fruit?
Well, as soon as I stepped into a river, a big flood brought down a landslide from the mountains and swallowed me up. Then, when I tried going into a lake, the seaweed suddenly multiplied and tangled around my body, nearly drowning me. And then, finally, when I tried jumping into the ocean, a huge whirlpool formed with me at its very center.
Huh. The Reaper's curse at play?
As far as I'm concerned, my Earth affinity and my Reaper's curse aren't much different, in that they've both shackled me since I came into being. This is about pushing and challenging the constraints I was born with.
Huh. So, did you eventually learn how to swim?
Pretty much, yeah. As long as I never let go of my portable life preserver.
Oh, huh.
Where's your portable life preserver? I need to know this. Okay, I'm gonna quick dart back in just to make sure there are no extra scenes. Aw, everybody's hanging out now. Would my mom come and see me? No, sweetie. Come, Moana. Come, Moana. We'll find our Therian this time. Hey, Velvet, how about a game of I Spy? I spy with my little eye something beginning with B. I can't see a thing. Are we talking about Bianfu, or are you insinuating something about me? Huh? Huh? So, what was she like? That's none of your business. Oh no. All right, let's get out of here.
Hey, Eizen, is there anything we can do about the prince's hawk? Griffin, I mean. Every day, it goes out on these hunts or whatever, and brings back the weirdest stuff. It's making a real mess out of the deck.
Hawks hunt? What's the big deal?
Well, yeah. At first it was bringing back good stuff like seaweed and fish, things we could cook with. Sure, I was glad for a while. But then it started to escalate. Now we're talking 150 kilo amber cans and 350 kilo killer swordfish that it's catching.
That's not a bad thing, is it? It just means more to eat.
It is when they're being dropped from the sky onto the deck. Especially those killer swordfish and razor sharp bills. What if somebody gets run through by one?
Can't you just warn the prince that his bird needs to be more careful?
Yeah, we could, but he looks so happy watching his hawk. I'd hate to spoil it for him.
Yeah, the prince looks so happy whenever Griffin is flying free. He kept grinning and asking Grocky all nice-like if he wanted to fly some more.
Grocky?
That's what Kamoana kept calling Griffin. She says she came up with it by combining Griffin and Hawk.
This is probably the first time in the prince's life that he's tasted any freedom. His whole life, he's only done what duty dictated of him. Letting Griffin fly was his first free act. To the prince, Grocky is an extension of who he is.
So what are we going to do?
Nothing, really. It's not like it really hurt anybody.
But it's punctured some major holes on the deck!
I'm sure even the prince knows when to rein it in. Let him have a little fun. He deserves it.
I don't know about all that. I'd say the prince is letting his newfound freedom get the better of him. Hey, I was just up on deck and it looks like Griffin's caught an elephant tuna this time.
An elephant tuna? That's the really big tuna that can swallow a killer whale whole, right?
That almost sounds like a demon to me.
Yep. Huge fish, gills like elephant ears. I saw it myself. From the looks of it, I wouldn't be surprised if it was a demon. It's crazy valuable. On a good day, it can fetch 20 million gold on the market. But there's something ominous about seeing it hovering in the air above the ship.
20 million gold? I take back everything I said. The Prince and Griffin can do whatever they want.
Did she say above the ship?
Uh-oh.
Oh, hell. Benwick, we need to stop Prince Percival.
Aye, aye, sir. Hey, don't drop that on the deck! Are you listening to me?
Oh, no! Well, the ship seems to be okay. So, yep. The skipper's letter is a forbidden subject among the crew. Best to leave it alone. And with that warning out of the way, we're ready to set sail. Oh, we're not gonna leave it alone forever, though. All right, let me see. We haven't gone here yet, so let's go ahead and do that. All right, then. Let's go.
I'll show you the beauty of my spear work.
Yeah.
helping each other out. Right.
Are you hurt? Can you stand?
Yeah.
All right then. Well, that was simple enough. Let's see if there's a cat's box in here, though. Which so far there has been, so... don't see why there wouldn't be. Oh my goodness, my voice. About to lose it there for a minute. Yay, I have just enough. And my expedition has returned. I think I... okay, got everything there.
Scout ship.
I did. We are on there. Okay, wow. Thought for a second that I had canceled it somehow. Do-do-do-do-do. Let's go, guys. I am going to take this time to go to... some different ports. I want to check just to see if there are any scenes or anything like... see, there is right up there. What have we got going on?
Did you guys hear? The search party that went to the Laban tunnel was wiped out by a demon.
Really? They were the ones out searching for Count Capulus, weren't they?
You mean the one who managed to get kidnapped? Despite everyone else at his manor, servants and children alike, getting killed? You'd think noblemen like that would have some decent exorcists among their personal guard.
Suppose he did. But I heard every blade there, sword and spear alike, was found chipped and cracked to hell.
Hmm. What kind of demon could do that?
Who are the Capuluses?
They are one of the great noble lines, on par with Oscar's Dragonia family, and have served Midgand for generations.
People refer to them as the royal family's hidden dagger. Unlike me, you never hear good rumors about them. They say behind the royal family's glory lies blood and tears shed at the hand of the Capulus family.
But those are just rumors. Although I do know that in recent times, the Count had stood against the rise of the Abbey.
I couldn't care less about the whereabouts of some noble. But we should be careful of the demon that took out all those exorcists.
Yeah, it sounds like a worthy opponent.
You know, it does. And I'm curious, is this something that's around here somewhere? Hmm. Well, I don't see any other scenes in town. Oh, there is a new request, though. Oh, a couple of new requests. Okay, East Laban Tunnel Underground Passage. Is that? Fog Shrouded Mystery in the Duval Forest, Aldina Plains, and... let me see. I haven't actually messed with the map too much here. Okay, there's the tunnel. And it is near Vortigern in Lothingen. Which is, yeah, on the way out here. So we can go through there. I see that there is, in fact, a little exclamation mark over that area. So,
there's something over there too. Where is that? Port Cadnix. I don't know. I haven't looked at the map like this before. I guess this is where... The Vester Tunnels also has something in it. Okay, well, then I think we should go ahead and head out this way and see if we can't figure out what's going on with this guy and apparently a demon that may have attacked him. Although, I have doubts that that's actually what happened. So... let's save real quick on our way. And since this is probably going to be quite a walk, I'll be back with you guys once I get there. All right, guys, we're back into the tunnels here, which, yeah, I actually jumped into a little bit before and left after a little while. But by the way, if I have been completely missing these side quests in the map, I don't know how. Someone let me know if I've been absolutely completely missing these. I'm going to be very, very upset at myself. But, see if we can't get through here and find this demon and what's going on. Gonna go this way. Ah, go away. Oh, this is where the teleporty is. All right. Ah! Oh, God! Floric ribbon. All right. Yeah, can you please leave me alone? Thank you. You know what? Let's go here. I'm not sure where this is exactly. Okay, so... looks like this would be where we, the direction at least, where we need to go. Ah, yes it is. Okay, anything in this? Aha, yes there is. Whoa. All right then.
Are we ready for this?
Maybe. Level 36, so I would hope so.
Was a close one, but I am the victor.
then...
I wasn't good enough.
What do you mean? That demon was really strong.
I don't mean the demon. I mean me. If Shigure were here, he'd have sliced it clean in half.
But you use shorter dual blades rather than just one bigger one like him, so of course...
No. He'd have done it with a shorter blade, too.
You can't be serious.
He's right. I think Shigure might really be capable of that.
Yeah. He's done it before.
Can I ask you a question?
I don't mind. You want to know more about my clan?
Yeah.
Well, as the eldest son, Shigure became head of the clan and ran things for a while. But 3 years ago, a rumor started floating around that he was planning an insurrection, and our lord immediately called for his execution.
Oh, wow.
Sounds like he doesn't waste any time.
Shigure never particularly cared about our lord to begin with. All he ever respected was personal strength.
Then did your lord send you to do the job?
Yeah. The only thing that can take down a Rangetsu swordsman is another Rangetsu swordsman. I thought I could handle it. I knew his every trick and had the time and place all planned out. But when it happened...
You got your ass beat.
Yeah. He made a fool out of me. I came at him with a great sword, and he just used a small one. All the training I'd done, I couldn't land a hit on him.
A rude awakening, if there ever was one.
Damn straight. I couldn't deny it. Shigure cast aside my great sword and just laughed. Train harder, he told me. I was so frustrated by my weakness, my inexperience. So much so that I wanted to end my own life. So much so that I turned into a demon.
Rokuro.
In the end, Shigure escaped, and I was arrested for failing to perform my duty and sent to the prison island.
And the rest, as they say?
So you regret not being able to kill your brother, huh?
I know it sounds crazy, but that's just who I am.
I'm not here to judge you. I'm just using you for my own purposes. As long as you fight my enemies, that's all that matters.
That's the plan. That's what I do best as a demon.
That's really, sad all around. That... I mean... To a certain extent, I understand that that was the way that he was raised. To follow your lord's, you know, orders no matter what it was, which would include killing your brother upon his order. But, I mean, not that I think that that's a correct order, but I understand that part of it. But at the same time, it's also sad that, you know, yes, he went to go kill his brother and then couldn't do it. And then he was punished for not being able to, not because he was unwilling, but because he wasn't able to. That's, you know, that definitely sucks. So, oh, I remember now. Eleanor, there we go. So that's definitely in the area of certainly not fair. But it is what it is at this point. He's a demon now, and he still wants to do what he was supposed to do in the first place, and not simply because he was told to, but because he needs to prove to himself that he's strong enough. Which, I mean, again, while I don't agree with it, I don't entirely begrudge him for, you know, again, that's the way he was brought up. No, everybody leave me alone. All right. The long walk back out of here. Give me. Okay. Okay, what else do we have? We need to go investigate the Earth Pulse Point, but there's also this quest for the Long Dao Dust, which was... Where was this? The Vester Tunnels. And that was on... Let me see, what town was that near? Ugh, this is... I don't really like their map system. Port Cadnix. So, let's go ahead and do that as well, because I definitely want Lafayette to be able to put that all together and help that kid out as well, his new best friend. So we'll head off in that direction once we get back to the boat. Okay, I lied. I just used one of those teleport bottles, actually, to teleport to Port Cadnix. So let's head out of the tunnels. Ugh. Oh, we're actually in the Vester tunnels already. So. And we can't go that way. Actually, should have gone into the town now that I'm thinking about it, see if there was any anything to do in there. But let's see. It's all the way into the in the tunnel depths. So we need to go around. Okay. Not a problem. We'll get there. I'm remembering these tunnels a bit better now. I got lost in them before. At one point, I was very lost. Okay, should be almost there. I am actually, since I'm not entirely sure what's going on here, I'm going to quick save. Just in case, since I haven't saved since before I fought that other demon. Am I in the wrong place? I thought I went into the right. But this isn't right. Ugh, where am I? Why is it so easy to get lost in here? It does say tunnel depths. Okay. All right, well, we'll hopefully figure this out. Let's just try going up this way and seeing. I think this is just a dead end, but. Oh, this is gonna bother me so much. Alright, well, can't hurt to look, I suppose. There's orbs and things in here. There's a way we cannot go yet. Maybe I actually can't do this until there's a certain point when I can fly or whatever. But for now, you know, I'm gonna check the workshop real quick. I mean, it does show a save point. So, maybe it's in the workshop. It is in the workshop. Oh my gosh. This is me being terrible at map reading. Worn spear. That's nice.
This must be Long Dao's dust. The ingredient Videl's Omega Elixir recipe calls for.
I can't believe you actually found it.
We have to go tell Videl. Maybe he's been able to translate the rest of the list.
Yeah.
And Videl is in Port Renied. So, I have absolutely no problem with teleporting, I've got some teleport bottles I can use, and since I wanted to come here anyway, let's quickly look around town and see if there's any, excuse me, cat, excuse me, or, I'm sorry, that is a bunny. Right, I'm not seeing any other quests, so nothing. Is there a treasure chest in here? Yes. Why, thank you, treasure chest. Super kind of you. And we can go back to Port Renied via the ship. Awesome. Do-do-do. coming, Videl. We're gonna give you an awesome thing, and he can be excited. And him and Lafayette can go, like, just absolutely pore over that book. Like, adorable little Sore and McLeo nerds. Hey, kid!
Wow! Is that Long Dao's dust? That's one of the Omega Elixir ingredients!
I know!
You found it! You really found it!
Yeah. It's proof your research is right.
Thanks! I've just managed to translate the description of the second ingredient. Here, take this and... Oh.
What's wrong? Your face is red.
Hey.
He's sick?
I'm burning up.
It's fine. I'm pretty much always running a fever.
That makes it even worse. We need to get you home so you can rest up.
But I'm still translating the recipe.
You heard me.
All right. She's scary. Is she your sister or something, Laffy said?
Well, it's kind of a long...
Sort of.
Oh, okay. Well, you seem to have a pretty complicated life.
Do you think he's always that sick?
Wouldn't surprise me. I was weak when I was a kid, too.
He's probably been like this since he was born. That must be why his parents named him Videl. It means to live.
Huh. I never thought about that.
Lafayette is like that too. It means one who lives.
One who lives.
And he wants to be an explorer when he grows up. I feel sorry for him.
But if he drinks the Omega Elixir, I think he can get better. When he sets off on his adventures, will you let him aboard the Von Eltia, Eizen?
I suppose I could cut him a deal.
You'd charge him?
I'm a pirate, kid. Comes with the territory. But I promise you, I won't charge him too much.
I suppose that'll have to do.
One who lives. I did not know that Lafayette's name had meaning behind it.
Didn't mean much in the end. I poured my soul into getting him through, but he's still dead all the same. Hope. What a waste.
You really think it was pointless?
What else am I supposed to think? It won't bring him back.
Aww. Thanks for being a mood killer, Velvet. Jeez.
I knew this would be big. What a treasure.
Eizen, so excited. Ooh, the master of trivia.
Scout.
Okay, do we have unicorn horn? Where is the unicorn horn? Here, let's just do it this way. Do we know? There we go. Let me see, where... Beardsley. Have we been to a town called Beardsley? Oh, it's okay. It's that little town near Helleves. But I don't think we can go back to Helleves right now, so we won't be able to do that right now. So I'll call it an episode there, and next time we'll head off to try to find our new Therian. So thanks everyone for watching, and I'll see you then. Bye!